World Games 2022, Birmingham, Alabama, flag football at Legion's Field, the debut of a new sport to the World Games in flag football, and we have the bronze medal match for the men's, Austria and Mexico. As we go inside Legion Field, an historic field here in Birmingham, Alabama, for this match. Both teams looking to rebound from losses with the opportunity here to take home the bronze medal action. Field playing a little bit warmer today. Flag football, the rules are a bit different than what we may be accustomed to a typical American football game. The flag's coming into play.
Yeah, no, look, absolutely. And this is to try and take this game globally. Real push to try and get this into the Olympic Games in Los Angeles in 2028. And been really impressed by the European teams as well. And this is two emerging nations. So Mexico coming up against an Austrian team that you know are well-drilled. We saw their women last night almost upset the United States. So clearly they are well and truly ingrained in flag football. So you will just notice the two flags either side, really, and that is the equivalent of the tackle. And rather than using the word tackle, which we will often use, it is just basically saying they have been deflagged. And so the quarterback for the Austrians is Felix Waschhuber. So Waschhuber, in fact. So Waschhuber sets. Looking, decides to go long, straight down the middle, but not open. Good defense coming from number six for Mexico, Carlos Espinoza. So good coverage there from Espinoza. You read it well.
Great job by the defensive secondary. And in this game, you'll have three wide receivers, person to hike the ball. You can rush the quarterback as well and grab that flag for a safety. Four downs to work with.
Yeah, interesting too that we sort of see that Austria are happy to go long early. Maybe just trying to get a bit of a read on this Mexican defense here, but another opportunity. Drops back in the pocket, third down, and very good take. And that is outstanding there from Johannes Prandtl.
Nothing long, so they go with a short route out. And it's fourth down now. They've got to make it to that midfield, that orange pylon that runs across midfield, to keep this series alive or go for it all, go for a TD.
Yeah, absolutely. So what do they do here? Do they look to just try and go short? Let's have a look at the coverage here being offered by Mexico. And they do decide and picked off. Good defense from the Mexicans. Read it well. Basically sacked the quarterback. Well, there was no flag. It was very much incomplete. May as well have been sacked. And Ivan Mendez simply read that well, didn't he? They had good coverage, even if that pass had got away.
Super job with a great arm's length to get into the passing realm. So Mexico will take over on downs.
Yeah, and immediately the catch is taken into out of bounds. The clock will stop. And so Guillermo Villalobos, who works very well with their quarterback, and Victor Belderamos. And keep an eye on the Mexicans. They're not afraid to be innovative as well. Now this time they look to go long, or pretend to go long. And open there on that left-hand side. They find that wide receiver, which is Bruno Espinoza. So really good start by the Mexicans.
Pretty close to that pylon there for the first down. And Balderamos having plenty of time in the pocket to size up his receivers. Espinoza getting to the corner there, coming on his route, coming back short to make that catch.
He's not the tallest quarterback, is he, Balderamos? But he's got great instincts. So now they send the man forward. Does get a hand on it, but it is not incomplete. And therefore taken by Bruno Espinoza. But not a lot in it. And that was good defense from Austria. Almost created the intercept. Just have a look here. But in the finish,
you can see Balderamos from that backside checking his receivers, knowing that Espinoza was just over the line there, good enough for four more downs.
Yeah, Benedict Wolf for the Austrians. Keep an eye on him. He is very good defensively. Gets a good read on it. And now they do, just another bullet pass. So not looking to go long. And I think the Austrians just need to make a wee adjustment here. They're sort of sitting back a little bit. And suddenly Mexico turning, coming back. And a pretty open, take the pass comfortably for Jorge Oliveira.
Oliveira showing some great hips, gathering that ball in. A little deke move up and under. And really giving a hard time to Wolf, the defender, who was unable to make the play.
So Belderamos be looking to try get into the end zone here possibly. What have they got? See, this is one of the little plays they talk about. Not happy to throw that little lateral pass. And now looks to run. Can they get that flag before he hits the touchdown? And touchdown, is it? Touchdown called. You can see the emotion from the Mexican. Look at what it means to Jorge Oliveira. Really, really hard defensively to cover that.
Really nice start here. They go with the lateral first. Nothing is there. So initially, if it was the initial pass off the snap, you cannot run with the football. You cannot run with the football. So the lateral back, nothing there for Oliveira. And as the lateral comes back, he is able to run and run for an easy six. They're going to go for two here.
I'll get you just to explain why, what the difference between how you get two rather than one and what the differences in terms of securing that extra point and arguably what would be considered to be the equivalent of kicking off the back of a touchdown.
Nice job by Salazar. There was plenty of time for Oliveira and the sack jump by the Mexican squad. A much better start than they had last evening in the semifinals against Italy, where they struggled early on, found themselves behind two touchdowns.
Just people watching this, why the 2 points there, not the 1 point?
Sure, the 2 points, you can go for 1 point if you take it the snap from the 5 yard line. You get 2 points if you take the snap off the conversion from the 10 yard line.
So just for people at home watching flag football that might not be familiar with it. So second down now for Austria at the 12-yard line. A little bit of work here to be done, but Felix Vashuber, their quarterback, he brings plenty of experience. Very athletic, very tall man. Get a good read on the defense here of Mexico. So the snap comes back again. Happy to go down the middle.
Oh,
did he? No, they've incomplete is the call. I'd like to have another look at that, but they've said incomplete. So, Martin Sturr, the receiver, he didn't quite have control, did he?
Could probably feel the pitter-patter of the secondary on him as he tried to gather that ball in. This is expected to be a pretty high-scoring game between these two teams. They're very efficient on their passing attack. We'll watch the rush as Mendez looking to rush in here and try to get a flag.
This time, much better from the Germans, but from the Austrians, my apologies. And taken by Daniel Hotchleitner. So Hotchleitner, that'll just calm the nerves for him for the Austrians.
Working up under center here, a little shuffle pass, nice move with the hips.
Oh, they clearly felt that they only needed inches to get that first down.
And we have a flag. Looks like illegal use of the hands.
Shielding is the call against the offense.
Okay, so number 11 there just preventing the tackler from being able to come in and grab that flag. So small margins in it. Johannes Prandtl just acting in a illegal blocking maneuver. Call it in rugby shepherding.
So we have a loss down, the penalty on the offense. So you lose a down. 5 yards.
Replay,
they're actually going to replay the fourth down here. So they've got to get to this pylon at midfield in order to keep the series alive, or will they go for it all?
So Mexico looking to rush the quarterback under a little bit of pressure. Goes down the middle. Great catch. That is outstanding. And the man, Martin Sturr, being brought in, got nice and high. Great reception. Just have a look at this under all sorts of pressure. Wouldn't look out of place in an NBA side, would he? Fantastic from the Austrians. Very clinical. So it's Mexico leading Austria 8-0.
Wide receiver spread spread, two on the near side, one on the far side. A little quick out pass by the Austrian squad, and Stir once again back-to-back receptions.
Yeah, Joshua Olivio, the defender for Mexico.
2:20 minute halves as the time continues to run here in fives, the bronze medal match between Mexico and Austria.
Yeah, good drive downfield this for the Austrians. They've been patient. Now they look to try and go long. Do they find somebody open? They do. And that is simply superb. Again, great set of hands from Daniel Hotleitner. Big tall man, but an outstanding pass from Velik Vasuba. Got a really good sense of space, hasn't he? Great cohesion, great understanding between these two.
Runs the bro right to the pylon towards the inside of the end zone. And a nice job, as you mentioned, his height. Certainly taking advantage of the secondary with an extra good few inches on his opponent.
And I think this is why this sport is going to become the real global point of view in terms of, let's say, gridiron American football, is because anyone can play at any size, and they do pick up the conversion.
Great job, right over the middle. It's always tough when you're getting that catch over the middle, in the middle of the secondary. You have to really find that seam. So the one-point conversion is good, 8-7.
Now Valderramos for Mexico finds his right-hand wide receiver and comfortably picked up by, again, Carlos Oliveira.
Mexico trying to work with a little bit of a fast pace here as they gain 7 yards on the play.
This time, good defense. Don't make a lot of yardage there, but they edge closer to that first down, that orange marking on either side of the field.
Yeah, Mexico getting up to the line real quick here.
Oh, little fake. This time they play the lateral. They're happy to play the dual quarterback. Steps, looks to go. Great defense from Austria. They scrambled, they covered. But great screen defense from the Austrians. But there is a penalty flag. Let's see which way this one goes.
Trying to find Valderramos there on that little short route, just enough to get over the line to keep this series going, get a new fresh set of downs. It will be on the offense. So it will be a loss of down for Mexico. Possibly trying to rush this offense a little bit too much, force them into that foul play, and the flag being thrown. See Valderramos there off the snap. Fourth down now.
Yeah, I'm not sure they need to be as perhaps unorthodox as they have been at this point in the game. Oh, great, straight down the middle, wide open. Finally, there is a bit of coverage coming from the Austrians, and it was for Austria that got across. Benedict Wolf, the catch taken by Guillermo Villalobos. As we go back and have a look at that replay. I do love that Mexican uniform with that little Aztec. Certainly does remind me of the ice hockey franchise, the San Jose Sharks. And now, happy to play a little patient game here, throwing it back and forward. Can they find the end zone? They can. Touchdown, or is he out of bounds? Touchdown!
Got the foot in just in time. A nice job by Jose Salazar. He wants to do the dance. They're really enjoying this one tonight as they throw it up and lay it down. And got to be careful there.
Interesting, wasn't it, with that lateral and deciding not to really go forward of the line of scrimmage, that it drew the Austrian defenders forward, which created plenty of space at the back. Really nice work to move from the Mexicans. Got to be careful though, got to make sure that you are catching those little lateral passes. Don't want to turn it over, but it's clearly a part of the Mexican game. We saw it in that semi-final yesterday against the might of Italy. They were in that contest.
So they're going to take it back here. This is going to be for the conversion attempt.
Not too long. So, gambled a little bit. Didn't pick up a point or 2 points on the conversion. Going to take some risks. I'll keep saying it. Las Vegas wasn't built on winners.
6.5 to go here as the time continues to tick. 2:20 minute halves with the clock running as Austria now will take over. And with that extra point being no good, this really opens the door here for Austria to march down the field, get a touchdown, and possibly go for two and take a one-point lead. Let's see how they do. Nearly picked off there.
Yeah, no, Felix Vashuber under just a little bit of pressure here. So Mexico just really having no one in front, no one really blocking. Austria guilty of just opening the door for that Mexican defense to come in and put Vashuber, the quarterback, under a little bit of pressure. So he goes to his notes. What's the scenario here? What is their strength?
Well, in this shotgun format for the quarterbacks, you notice they're about 10 yards back. Shotgun became a prevalent word in the United States from the old Dallas Cowboy squads of Tom Landry. And they were the ones that really made that efficient back in the day. And in this type of game of flag football, it certainly helps, instead of being under center, forces the rushers to have to run a little bit further to try to grab that flag. And certainly works well in this passing type atmosphere of the flag football.
Got some work to do, third down and 13. So got to go long here. Certainly got to get incomplete again. And just the hands letting Austria down at critical times. Number 13, Martin Stur. He's better than that. He knows it. That's twice now for Stur. But again, very, very good pressure from Mexico. It's almost like they're whispering in your ear. Don't blink, I'm here.
Fresh set of downs for Austria now as they move upfield. Vashuber calling out the play. We'll see if he finds his favorite target, number 13, Stur, here on this play.
Yeah, this time, big moment in this game. Oh, that's better. Much better and improved from Daniel Hochleitner. And does get the first down. So under pressure, Austria rise to the occasion. Really good here.
Runs the route tight, right to the flag. And knew exactly where he needed to be to that pylon to garner that first down and the new fresh downs for Team Austria.
So on halfway, good drive here from Austria. It hasn't been pretty at times. And they go to the same man again. Flag is taken, but once again, it is the very impressive Hochleitner. Interesting that they're going to Leitner, maybe just Martin Stur in the number 13. His hand's just letting him down a little bit. So there is a penalty. There is a flag on the play. Pass interference.
Following the catch and penalty ball is spotted at the 14-yard line.
You've got to grab the flags, and if you don't grab the flags and you grab a piece of the clothing or the body to try to impede the runner or receiver from garnering downfield, that could also garner a reason for a flag to be called on the team. So the ball will move down the field just a little bit further on that play and that miscue. This Mexican squad needs to make sure that they focus in and don't have penalties called on them to hurt them and their opportunity here for a bronze medal as they close in inside the 9-yard line.
3 minutes remaining on the clock. Philip Vashuber, the quarterback for Austria. Oh, the lovely little wraparound run around. Gets within the 5-yard line before that flag is stripped. Deflagged. Johannes Prandtl. Interesting here, it's the first real time that we've seen that little layoff.
Nice fake. I wouldn't call it a play action, as we are accustomed to, but pretty darn close to it. Fake to one, and then a nice wraparound handoff by Prandtl showed his speed to get to the outside over the line of scrimmage.
Again, in that role of this time they go long. Or does he get his foot on the line? No. Incomplete. Did catch it, but just let's just have a look here.
Nice heave, tight spiral there, and great athleticism that we see from these world-class athletes, and just a smidgen of getting that left foot down inside the end zone.
Yeah, great officiating, isn't it? Wonderful. Back to the drawing board, though. They know there is plenty of channels.
to thread that needle for the touchdown in that end zone. Interesting setup here from the Austrians, equally interesting setup from the Mexicans. Goes across, looks it, and very well orchestrated, and that is the class of the Austrian, Gregor Brouwer, with the touchdown. So they are not afraid to mix it up in terms of the players that they are going to. They're not going to say, look, we're just a one-trick pony here.
1 point try here.
And they're going to go for the one-point conversion.
That was Brouwer's first reception of the game. No better way to make it than find a way to the end zone for 6 points.
So, can they pick up the extra point here and bring it within one? I bring it tied up at 14 each. And it is the extra point. So, nice comeback from Martin Stur, whose hands have just let him down a little bit in this bronze medal match. As that clock counts down, wonderful game beginning to ensue. It is Austria and Mexico tied up.
Nice job getting right over the goal line there. You have to know exactly where to run your routes in flag football, and that's part of the plays and the schemes that you're drawing up. And Stur doing a good job. Found the pylon, found the goal line, made his hook curve inside for that reception to tie this up at 14.
So Belderamos, then, yeah, plenty of space. Really open, but good reception again from Espinoza. He is a very reliable player. He's got really good hands.
At the 23, third down and 2 yards to midfield.
So third down, 2 yards. So they just look to run that short route. And they do. Just that slightly almost lateral type pass. Sidearm. And Delarosa gets the job done. And first down to Mexico.
Austria is giving Mexico the deep pass, and I mean the short pass right now. They're really trying to cover the secondary and speed of Team Mexico. Mexico knows that they have those short routes open if need be as a safety. It's a perfect example of it right there. No one going in towards the end zone. And a great job by Guillermo Villalobos for the reception.
Yeah, I think one of the reasons why this will become just such a global phenomenon and just see it popularized around the world is it's not the stop-start that we get with the American football, which I think frustrates a lot of international audiences with the stop-start that you tend to get in the NFL. This is fast, and everybody gets their hands on the ball, which is what makes it very, very cool. And look at the innovation here from the Mexico. This is another part that makes this game very cool. And now, twice, looks to turn. Do they manage to grab it? They don't. Runs into the end zone and does that little NFL dance. So, turned nothing into something. Turned on a dime. The Austrians will be a little bit frustrated that they didn't deflag him. Just have a look here. Desperation coming from Daniel Killed the defenseman for Austria.
It really all came from the snap. Espinoza sliding in underneath center there for the snap, for the snapper, and that little decoy to Oliveira really opened up the opportunity, because then the defensive secondary had to decide, okay, we're playing deep to protect against the pass, and Oliveira showing his speed for the easy six.
And so looking to just take the 1 point here on the conversion. And they managed to get it too, so 21-14 with 48 seconds remaining in the first half, but it is very close. Both sides, when they've had possession, have gone on some very good drives. They've managed to get numerous first downs. Mexico probably playing the more unorthodox, but the precision of the Austrians, well, it is pinpoint accuracy at the moment. So another chance here for Felix Vashuber.
Enough time here with the clock winding down, inside 40 seconds to go. Going out of bounds there as the clock stops. But Mexico has been extremely efficient with their offense, scoring on every single offensive opportunity. See if Austria can cap the first quarter here with six.
Here we go. Looking to straight down the middle. good defense. What are they flag on the play? Too aggressive there, I think, from Mexico. Possibly the player that might just be penalized here is number 26, Joshua Olivo. Just a little shove in the back. Well, there you go. 10-meter penalty, automatic first down.
That hurts really, and it stops the clock as well. So not only is it a penalty on an incomplete pass, but it moves the ball 10 yards, stops the clock. So Austria with a good opportunity here to go over what they're going to call, and as you can see, with a fresh set of downs.
Yeah, it's a tough one, isn't it? Because your intuition just takes over. It's just in the split second. You see the ball, and your natural instinct is to want to go for it. But I think this would just be a fabulous sport to see in the Los Angeles Olympics in 2028, particularly for the host nation, the United States.
They'll be meeting in the winter months of this coming year to make that decision. And certainly this sport has made its claim. The games have been close. They've been exciting for the fans to watch. And it's really been a national setting.
Well, we saw yesterday in the semifinal, the Austrian women almost beating the United States. We've seen the quality of this game here. Straight down the middle, lovely little play there from Austria, and they get across the halfway line now. Time is just starting to run down. They've taken a timeout just to stop that clock. 22 seconds does remain, and great reception once again from Johannes Prandtl. Try and go out of bounds here, or do they go deep into the end zone? That's the question they'll be asking themselves.
Yeah, I think what they'll do is they'll run two guys to the end zone, try to take away the defense and the clamor around that, and then run a short route to try to get something out of bounds here.
Just get some clarity. Is the quarterback allowed to run this into the end zone?
No, the quarterback cannot run it into the end zone. There has to be a pass made first. As we're seeing those laterals, the laterals actually have to go slightly back to go forward. So that initial lateral does have to be made.
So 20 seconds remain. Trail by a touchdown. Now they look to go. He is open. Steps out. Brilliant. Great thinking under pressure there from Daniel Hotchleitner. He was aware of the clock, the pressure, and he just steps out of bounds. You can just see that split second. Yes, decides. Yep. Happy to step out of bounds. So another chance here, and they look for the end zone. They go short. Touchdown. And the flag on the play. Touchdown. And they'll also be penalized for that too. The physicality of the Mexicans, the discipline. You're going to have to be better than that. Daniel David Ramirez, possibly the guilty party there, but brilliant athleticism from Johannes Prandtl.
You cannot have contact. That's why it's flag football. And there's no tackling allowed. Aggressiveness by David Ramirez on that play. Not going for the flag, but going for the body. So the flag and the penalty will be assessed on the possession return the opposite way.
So they have given the touchdown, though, haven't they?
Yes, yep. Because he had gotten into the end zone. So
now just checking that.
Half the distance to the goal for a 2-point drive.
We're going to go for a 2-point conversion here. Prandtl, nice catch to hold on, even with the body contact being made, for sure. Looks like they're going to put some time back on the clock.
So, Vashuba goes down, and they will pick up the extra 2 points. And heading into halftime, it will be Austria leading 22-21.
Five seconds to go in the first half. Austria 22, Mexico 21.
So here goes Mexico. So a lot of whistling going on. We'll just see if we can pick up what the issue is.
Stand illegal procedure.
So they'll repeat the first down with 6 seconds to go here and put a couple seconds back up on the clock.
Really, it's going to be a little bit of a Hail Mary here, isn't it? I think they're just going to throw everybody forward unless they look for that lateral.
I like the war paint.
They'll see if they can run the full length of the field, but the fields are just not wide enough that once the defenders react, they're going to get across. So expect to see a Doug Flutie type pass.
Jorge Oliveira with that war paint going on like that. Number 14 in white for Mexico, snapping the ball.
Oh, they do go wide. Does he step out of bounds? He does. So still 4 seconds on the clock. Really good from the Mexicans. Superb. And nicely picked up. Nicely read by Salazar.
We might have had a little bit too quick of a forward pass there. We have a loss of down for Mexico. So trying to work a little bit too quick here with the illegal forward pass. Half the distance of the goal line, too, on the penalty.
Well, I think that's all they can do now is drop deep into the pocket, deep into the end zone, and look to go long. Austria, we are aware of it, though. You can already see the number 7 for Austria has dropped right back. Maximilian Hillbrand.
Defensive backs and the safeties just saying, go ahead, try us.
So 4 seconds. Quick snap.
Nearly didn't get that one snapped off.
And that will bring it to the end of the first half, and it is Mexico trailing Austria 22-21 in this bronze medal match of flag football. It has had a little bit of everything, wonderful accuracy, it has had great cohesion, and it's also at times just had a little bit of physicality, which has ultimately probably just cost Mexico at key times. Like all sport at the highest level, discipline so important.
Bronze medal on the line here. I think Mexico has come out a bit stronger than they did certainly against their loss to Italy, 41-29. Really was playing catch up that entire game, playing with a lot more confidence. And Team Austria here, they, aside from that, really that first series down the field, they have had solid fluid motion with their catches and the way that they have played consistently.
The Mexicans, the way they play the laterals, is that something that, is that an innovation from them, or is that quite common in flag football? Is that, I guess, established play? Or is it considered still to be a little unorthodox?
No, it's established play, and one of the plays in the laterals, the hook and ladder type play where you'll see the lateral pass and then the long throw downfield. So it is quite customary. It is just another aspect and flow and scheme into the offensive attack for a team. Certainly, I think Mexico has shown a lot more emotion on their sleeve in that first half of play. Sometimes maybe possibly not keeping it in check, which hasn't completely hurt them penalty-wise. But I think with the score being so close here and everything being on the line, they'll have to watch that here in the final 20 minutes of play with the bronze medal on the line.
Yeah, it's certainly a thoroughly entertaining sport. I was lucky enough to play a little bit of touch some years ago while I was visiting Dallas, Texas, and getting into that little huddle and having that quarterback call the play. Mark, I want you to run 20 yards forward and then cut back and then drop back 5 yards and the ball's coming your way. And for a young lad from down in New Zealand, it was a thoroughly enjoyable experience. And that, of course, now has been formalised into this flag football. And it's flag football that's also changed rugby around the world. They've got flag rugby now for most of the young kids that play rugby in predominantly the Commonwealth.
The sport has originated here in the United States, and over the last, I would say, 10 years, we have seen flag football really take off at all levels. The National Football League is a big backer of this flag football in the United States, and you will see it now through the high school level, where it is extremely competitive, and the opportunities now at the college level to be playing flag football, not just club sport anymore.
Well, Delta Ramos not successful on that play, going through the hands of Oliveira. first real sort of handling mistake we have seen from Mexico. And this time they look to go long, straight down the middle. Lovely reception from Guillermo Villalobos.
Villalobos with his strength and height, this kind of see from Valderrama's exactly what he's looking at, as Villalobos ran his pattern to the middle of the field, stuck his hands up and says, I'm here as one of your options, and gathering that one in.
Oh, great pass, bullet pass, really good reception, and that is fantastic from Salazar. It's hard, isn't it? You've got your quarterback, you've got four attacking options, and your defenders have got to try and figure it out.
You know, and you think about this, these are athletes, like all the world-class athletes that are here at the World Games, where they have occupations during the day. And another flag is the aggressiveness now by Team Austria, as Sebastian Wolf, not going for the flag, but going for the body, and flags coming out everywhere.
Love to have a look at this again, because really he just held his ground, I thought. I thought he just stood there hard, and it was just a simple case of momentum coming into it, but they didn't read it that way.
No, 10-yard penalty on that illegal contact by Wolf, and that'll set up Mexico here.
Hey, Oliveira with the snap. Again, play the lateral. Lovely little 1-2. And this time it is the quarterback, Victor Valderrama's, who picks up the touchdown. Really well worked from the Mexicans. Very difficult to defend here. Just uses Espinoza. Espinoza acts as the quarterback. And Valderrama's moves from quarterback to receiver. This is the innovation of the Mexicans, very hard to defend against. But surely Austria must be aware now that they are going to play that lateral a little bit more. It's one thing knowing about it, it's another thing defending it over the top. And that's another wasted opportunity from Mexico in terms of picking up the extra point on the conversion.
Fake on the handoff there, trying to throw a decoy as we see a flag on the field. It's no good, it will go the other way, as that flag was called on Mexico. So Austria now with the ball, trailing 27-22 as the clock continues to tick.
You do sort of sense that it's going to be an intercept that's probably ultimately going to separate these two. It's going to be a piece of defensive brilliance, somebody being able to read the play. So Felix Vashuber, the quarterback for Austria, and goes up the middle. Now, is there contact there? What have they called that? And that looked like almost a replay of what happened down the other end. And let's be fair, Austria were heavily penalised for it.
But Prandtl doing the right thing, just chewing on his mouthpiece, not saying anything. But I would agree with you again. Ramirez, who had made that solid contact at the goal line, very fortunate on that play that the flag was not called.
Yeah, I mean, you just want consistency, don't you? It must have been a very fine line. They go long. Vashuber can't quite find his receiver. And the 10 for the Austrians, Sebastian Marolt.
Marolt being tightly guarded down the field there by Espinoza.
Third down and the 13.
This is a big down here for Team Austria. They need to get to midfield at least. They've got a long way to go. Will they air it out? Or will they shoot for that midfield pylon?
This time, create the perception, or create the illusion that they were going to go long. And that just put the Mexican defense in a little bit of a holding pattern. Let's have a look here. Sands comes back into play. Wow. Really nicely taken from Johannes Prandtl.
Big fourth down.
Very good. Oh, no, good defense. Good defense from Mexico. Is that how big a play is that in the context of this bronze medal? They only really had a meter for that first down. And just some hesitation there, maybe just trying to be a little bit too clever, Austria. Mexico read it beautifully, though. And as we always say, it's often defense that wins the biggest games.
Austria just did not look comfortable, even as they went to the line. They were looking at each other, trying to make a decision. And now the ball goes back to Mexico here with an opportunity to really go up in this game, but solid defensive effort by the secondary of Team Austria. Super job by Benedict Wolf.
Yep, no flag on the play here. Just have a wee look. Nope, he's just, his athleticism led to him taking, kissing the deck. So, Austria deciding they need to step it up defensively. Let's see what we can do. Do Mexico look to go with the lateral? Do they look to play that 1-2 again between Valderramos and Bruno Espinosa? No, it's time. Picked off again. Superb from Austria. Hillebrand.
Maximilian Hillebrand getting a hand on it, really read that play well. Just, there wasn't an opportunity for an interception, but he was going to break up the play, and he did so perfectly on that one.
Yeah, big moment now. Suddenly Mexico under real pressure. Their third down. Big long pass over the top. Austria forcing Mexico now to look to go long. I wonder whether they defensively bring two up on the outside, drop two back through the middle, give himself that option.
Starting to get real here on fourth down.
Yeah, what is the play here from Valderramos?
Got to be so careful too, because you're working out of the end zone. You don't want anyone to rip that flag. You don't want the 2 points to go the opposite way. Let's see what they do.
And now trying to be a little bit clever. It's not open. Surely they can get the... Oh, superb, superb from Mexico. Wow.
I think he may have had enough, Bruno Espinosa, for that first down.
Yeah, this time they do play that lateral. They realised that the Austrian defence had been too good. They needed to just put a bit of indecision into their head, create some doubt, and rely on their athleticism. And they do pick up the first down. And Mexico on a nice little run here. Just over the halfway line. They're very good, aren't they, Espinosa and Valderramos? They've got great chemistry, those two. They seem to be very much running the shots.
And Espinosa is going against Benedict Wolf, who has a real good 6 or 7 inches on him. So great footwork to get in front of Wolf to make that reception.
Yep, Jorge Oliveira again. He goes back to Espinosa. And back to Oliveira, and touchdown! It is very much a three-man show between Valderramos, Bruno Espinosa, and Jorge Oliveira. Both of them have the ability, all three of them have the ability to play in that quarterback position. Wonderful execution. It's simply superb pass. Pinpoint accurate. And Mexico now take a commanding lead in this bronze medal match. They lead 33-22. Austria are going to need to be the next team to score. And Mexico, I think, happy to probably just play the percentage here. They are looking for the extra point.
Nice job. Oh, the tip was there. You know, if Mexico doesn't keep the downs going on that great catch and play by Espinosa at midfield and the extra effort, that touchdown would not be had. So talk about a swing of action and emotion, keeping that play alive, even though they did not convert on the conversion. Certainly the difference right now of 11 points as we get down within single digits here of the second half of play.
Yeah, it's a great strength, isn't it, when you've got Espinosa, who can very much play as a quarterback. He's got a very good arm on him. Now, Felix Vashuber for Austria. They need to look to go the full length of the field here. Doesn't get deflagged and gain some extra valuable yards. He'll also pick up some more on the play. So, again, discipline, letting Mexico down. Outstanding.
David Ramirez. from Mexico. Just difficulty keeping control of his body after the play. This is not where you want to be picking up the flag. You'll see him come in from behind.
Yeah, and Prandtl for Austria. Lovely little step two, lovely little shimmy. Got a low center of gravity.
At the end of the play, the 10-yard penalty, as you saw there visually, the ball will move upfield, and another first down is, ball is at about the 16-yard line for Austria to work.
Now, nice. Picks out a very impressive Gregor Brouwer.
To the nine, second down.
So Austria happy to change their team, rotate through their squad based on what they're seeing from this Mexican defense.
Austria must score here to keep pace. They must. Clock is not in their favor.
And they go down the middle, they go long. Yeah, very good. Great athleticism. A foot certainly on the ground there. And you cannot argue that one. Gregor Brouwer, who was heavily involved in the earlier play. And it is touchdown, Austria. It is game on.
Gregor Brouwer getting past the secondary easy. They forgot all about him here. And a rocket and a bullet right to that back pylon of the end zone. Brouwer's second touchdown of the game, most needed, as the Austrian team goes for the conversion.
Just looking for the 1 point to bring the score within four. Picked off, great defense from Mexico, and I wonder how important that is in the context of this particular match. But also just for people watching at home who might be more familiar with American football and college football in the States, you need to have the 1 foot on the ground in the end zone. You don't need to plant both feet. But I think in any case he had both feet on the ground before going across the white line. Now chance back here for Mexico. Need some big defense from the Austrians though. They've been very good defensively. Mexico happy to play the percentages. Looks to try and turn on a dime. Jorge Oliveira.
And for Team Mexico right now, all they want to do is they want to stay in bounds. They want to keep this clock running. Move down the field, but there isn't any true urgency. If the play is there and they have it, fabulous, but just be a little bit more methodical. If you remember early on in the game, they were trying to move plays quickly at the line of scrimmage.
So Oliveira Jorge will snap the ball and go back to Valderramos, and happy to find his partner in crime in Bruno Espinosa.
To the 18-yard line, third down and seven.
But a third and seven play here. They're going to be forced to kind of rush things up a little bit more, get a free set of downs. Let's see what Austria's defense, their secondary, does to thwart this play. This would be a big stop and an opportunity for Austria, as Mexico must get to that midfield line and beyond it to keep their series of downs going. Third down now.
Valderramos sits back and he waits.
See Valderramos kind of turn around and peek at the shot clock behind him there.
Sits deep in the pocket and happy. Really good percentage play here once again.
Pass is caught by Quijano across midfield in the 21. First down, Mexico.
So it is a first down to Mexico. And as you talked about, just play the percentages at the moment.
Yeah, quick.
In control of the ball. They'll be happy to run the clock down to a degree as long as they ultimately do come up with the touchdown. It could backfire here. They don't need to panic. They don't need to be clever. Chance to play percentage football.
Don't need that deep route. Just little short routes. Keep things going.
And you called it. Great example of it. This time, Guillermo Villalobos. Must have family.
I think Guillermo sees his picture up on the big screen right now.
I tell you what, you could imagine in 228 in LA if this becomes a sport and the final is between Mexico. Mexico and the United States in California. Imagine the size of the crowd.
Absolutely.
And the atmosphere. Wouldn't it be just
totally
a wonderful thing?
Yes.
Well, just having the Mexicans there and them on their own, maybe taking on a European powerhouse. So set back deep in the pocket again, as is the case. Surveys his options, and really simple play once again from Mexico. And Jorge Oliveira, the receiver. And so Mexico showing that they can play percentage football, but at times can be incredibly innovative with that 1-2-3 lateral passing and going the short route.
Jorge Oliveira, who has been a big piece of the attack for Team Mexico today. We've seen him take snaps, we've seen him run well, we've seen him throw a couple times off of laterals, and a big player just 2 yards out now is Team Mexico as we head towards the 340 mark.
And touchdown, is it? Flag on the play. Now, which way does the flag go here? I reckon there might be a little bit of blocking going on here from Mexico.
Be a loss of down with that penalty on Mexico. So it's fourth down, loss of down as well for Team Mexico. Clock continues to run as they'll look at the play.
It might have just been a little bit of shepherding.
And on top of it, they go from the 2 yard line back now as it with the loss of down. Also the movement of the ball back.
Well, it's interesting, isn't it? How often in sport it just comes down to one or two key moments. And they can often be the difference. Is that one of them?
Yeah, the shot clock was winding down there. A little bit of confusion off of the penalty. That ball coming back. It's a 10-yard penalty on that, along with the loss of down. So they were at the 2. They're at the 12. Big difference on the snap now is Team Mexico goes over exactly what they want to do. They need the 6 here.
I think it's good here, the timeout. I think it's a very good tactical timeout as well. Just get another set of eyes, a little bit more discussion. And so the chance for the Austrians to maybe regroup. Particularly if a team starts to get a bit of momentum, you want to try and slow it down, take the timeout.
More look at the play as Villalobos comes out to the field, takes his position at the line.
So Belderra again playing the lateral here, going back. Now, are the options there in play?
Let's go!
They're saying that Villalobos was in as he takes a bow. And boy, that was extremely deceiving as they had two receivers that stayed in off of the initial pass. Started with Oliveira, went to Espinoza. Valderramos ended up taking the final throw downfield to Villalobos, who held on for the touchdown.
Yeah, great athleticism from Villalobos. Read it nicely, realized that he had to get down low. He's pretty much camped himself on the turf, took the catch, and therefore was never at any point in mid-air. And then I've got to say, just wonderful officiating as well. They called it immediately. No sort of action replay or no review required. And that is a decisive touchdown for Mexico with just 2 minutes remaining. And really all they have to do here, don't they? They just need to go for the 1 point. There's no... basically, Austria are going to have to score twice if they want to win this, so... They'll continue to play the percentage. That's what I've liked about Mexico. At times, when they've needed to, they've played the percentages. And when they've needed to get clever, they've got clever. And it's caused all sorts of problems for this Austrian defense.
Villalobos definitely with the big play here. Let's see what happens on the conversion.
So they're going to go for the 2 points. And they go long, deep into the end zone. Not successful. So 39 plays 28, 2 minutes remain. And what do Austria do here? Well, really, they need two possessions. They need almost need to go long, pick up a touchdown, and then try and somehow get the ball back. I'm not sure that...
As quick as they set up off of a catch or reception, they've got to get back to the line and start moving down the field once again. There can't be any time wasted.
No, and they also need to look to go wide, run the ball into out of bounds, stop the clock, because that clock continues to tick down, and they will feel the weight of pressure. Can't really afford to be too much of a discussion. So less than 2 minutes now, 1 minute 40 remains. Austria need to score twice. They go long. Waiting. Is he open? No. Good defense from Mexico, and that is the pressure. Felix Lasuba under. But
well, that least stopped
the clock.
Yeah, it stops the clock, and it allows Austria to get back into their quick huddle here and at least go over the scheme of at least two plays, so they'll know their scenarios as they step to the line of scrimmage from the 12.
Really, it's just a consistent throwing everybody forward, creating the idea that they might come short under pressure. Can't get himself out of bounds.
And Mexico will take that. They'll take that short pass with third down, fourth down now, as Austria needs to get to midfield or beyond. A minute going here. There's just not enough time left on the clock for Team Austria, and trying to get to your second possession back.
Just wasting time here. Now, I've got a feeling in the background the Mexican coach has been doused with the traditional Gatorade. Whatever they use these days, they feel they've won it. Austria look to go long. The big Hail Mary, nope. Infield, can he step out of bounds? Can't, so the clock continues. Really good from Mexico. Just happy to let them have the ball, keep them in play, and use the clock. Superb there from Joshua Manjiha.
For formalities here.
Sending everybody forward now. They will look again. That's what you do. You send everybody long, and certainly that is going to open it up. But that's not what they need.
Timeout taken by Austria here as they'll try to set up that final play of the World Games. Good look. You see that there is absolutely nothing long as Mexico doing a great job in covering the end zone with their secondary. They'll give up everything short. What does that do? That forces after the catch a long run, which takes more ticks off the clock.
So 39 plays 28. Austria, I think they know, have had some opportunities, but in fairness, I think Mexico have just been slightly better. They've just brought a little bit more to their game. Just a little bit more innovation at key times. Lasuba into the end zone, touchdown, and there we go. 39 will play 34 with the conversion to come. Great way to finish for Austria to get that close to Mexico. Probably historically more familiar with American football.
Gregor Bauer now with his third touchdown of the game. He has been the man in the end zone. We haven't heard his number called too much in the open field, but when they get down into that touchdown territory, he's been the person.
And they are successful picking up the extra point, 39-35. 8 seconds left on the clock. Everybody knows that bronze medal was going the way of Mexico. Big smile on their face. Huge for them. An emerging sport making its debut at the World Games. And great to have Europe and South America being represented. And they will just simply take a knee here, run that clock down. And there it is, it's all over. That is Mexico, the bronze medal, getting up over Austria, 39-35.
Team Mexico from the beginning with back-to-back touchdowns. Ending the first quarter into the second quarter. And Team Austria having to chase most of the game. I thought the backbreaker certainly was Villalobos' score late in the game to make it 39-28. And the celebration is on for Team Mexico as they take home the first bronze medal of these World Games in flag football. Great stage for men's flag football here, making its debut in the United States of America, where the sport has originated. But globally, it is on the board As you can see, the competition at the level of play, 39-35, Team Mexico over Austria. Should be Austria and Panama, women's bronze.
Versus Team Austria.